The United States, US, has developed a long-range hypersonic missile, LRHW, dubbed the Dark Eagle. This missile, if deployed on Guam, is claimed to be able to strike mainland China and targets in the South China Sea in seconds because it has a range of 1,723 miles and a speed of over Mach 5. The Dark Eagle missile is not yet officially operational. However, the US Army says it is getting closer to deploying it for the first time. The US military as a whole has accelerated its acquisition of hypersonic weapons as its arch-foe Russia has successfully tested and allegedly fielded three different types of hypersonic missiles: Avangard, Kinzhal and Zircon. In mid-August, US Strategic Command Chief Charles Richard, speaking at the annual Symposium on Space Defense, acknowledged that Russian hypersonic technology would give the Russian Navy an invincible advantage. The US Army recently received a trailer-mounted prototype Dark Eagle launcher along with other critical components of the complete weapon system at Joint Base Lewis-McChord in Washington State. The Army also released a series of images showing the arrival of these launchers on October 5, 2021. However, the image metadata suggests they were taken on September 14 or 15, 2021. According to the US Army, Joint Base Lewis-McChord will house the first units of this weapon system. The photos show the launcher when shipped. Each launcher is mounted on an M870, which has been modified and will be towed by an Oshkosh M983A4 tractor truck. This truck is a variant of the Heavy Expanded Mobility Tactical Truck, HEMTT. Although the official designation of the first LRHW units is unknown, images show that many of these launchers have been given individual names, such as Hyperion. The name Dark Eagle itself was announced by the US Army in August. According to reports by US media, two empty canisters similar to those that would house future Dark Eagle missiles were delivered to an undisclosed location earlier this year. The Army has also offered some details about the LRHW battery as well as its various components. This will be a four-launch battery, Bob Strider, Deputy Director of the Army's Office of Hypersonic Projects, told the Space and Missile Defense Symposium. While no missiles have yet been delivered to the US Army, the launchers along with other equipment are expected to familiarize soldiers with the LRHW and routine operation of the system. They are also expected to assist in supporting the development of tactics, techniques and procedures, TDPs. This is an important development for deploying these missiles in real-world scenarios. The caption associated with the latest image also notes that the LRHW prototype component has been built under the direction of the Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office, RCCTO.